This is Mr. Peterson with another screencast for Life Science. In this screencast, we're going to learn about the abiotic factors in an ecosystem. So let's get started. Here are your state standards. You do not have to write these, but just be familiar with them. Here are your learning objectives, and you need to have these available if I ever ask them. Yes, write them down. Recall that biotic factors are the living parts of the environment, and abiotic factors are the non-living parts of the environment. The importance of each abiotic factor varies from ecosystem to ecosystem, but they play an extremely important role in the environment. One abiotic factor is water. 71% of the Earth is covered with water. Most of Earth's water is found in the oceans. The rest is freshwater, and can be found in rivers, lakes, groundwater, glaciers, and water vapor. Air is another abiotic factor. It forms the atmosphere around Earth. 78% of air is nitrogen, 21% of air is oxygen, and 1% is a mixture of everything else, including carbon dioxide. Soil is a mixture of organic matter, minerals, gases, liquids, and organisms that together support life. Humus is an important part of soil. It is organic matter that is made up of decomposing plant matter. Since humus is organic, meaning it comes from organisms, it is considered a biotic part of the soil. Sunlight is the abiotic factor that is the source of energy for almost all life on Earth. It is used by autotrophs for photosynthesis, and its energy is passed on to consumers through food chains and food webs. Sunlight is a factor that determines climates on Earth. Temperature is a measure of how hot or cold something is. The temperature of an ecosystem is the temperature of the air. It is affected by latitude and elevation. Temperature affects which organisms can live in an ecosystem. Latitude is the degrees north or south of the equator. The highest temperatures are near the equator. The further you go away from the equator, the lower the temperature of the environment. Elevation is height above sea level. The higher you go up in elevation, the lower the temperature on average gets. That's why there tends to be snow on top of high mountains, like the one pictured here. Climate refers to the average weather conditions in an area over time. All ecosystems can have different types of weather every once in a while, but climate is the average over a long period of time. Climate includes temperature, precipitation, and even wind in the area. Now, let's talk about matter. Matter is any substance that has mass and takes up space. All biotic and some abiotic factors are made of matter. Matter is constantly cycled between biotic and abiotic parts of the environment. Recall that a food web shows how energy is transferred from one organism to another in many different ways, but it gets used up by each organism over time. So that was a little different than what we're going to talk about with matter cycles. The water cycle is a matter cycle because water is made of matter. It has mass and takes up space. There are five main events in the water cycle. Condensation is when water changes from gas to a liquid. Evaporation is when water changes from liquid to gas. Transpiration is the evaporation of water from a plant. And precipitation occurs when water condenses in the air, but then it keeps collecting and eventually falls back to Earth as rain, snow, sleet, or hail. Once it finally hits Earth, it is now runoff. Runoff is water that drains from areas of high elevation to areas of low elevation, pulled down by gravity. Another important matter cycle in ecosystems is the carbon cycle. Recall that carbon dioxide is a gas in the air. Producers use this carbon dioxide in the air for photosynthesis. Consumers release carbon dioxide into the air when they exhale, or after cellular respiration. Carbon is an element, and all organisms are made of carbon. So, when organisms die and decompose, the carbon from their bodies goes back into the soil. Fossil fuels are made from the carbon of organisms that lived millions of years ago. Burning these fossil fuels adds more carbon to the air. Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching.